Good morning, children. Today we have to do unit number 2, lesson number 5. So you are required to open page number 11 of your Oxford Progressive English book. Now children, you have already completed part 1. So we are going to start part 2, the three little goats part 2. Before reading, I will tell you the meanings of difficult words. So it will be easy for you to understand the story. And you will not get confused while reading. Here we go with our vocabulary building strategy. First word is climb. What is the meaning of climb? Go upwards or come up a slope or staircase. Now I'm going to share a sentence so the meaning will become further clear to you. Some animals climb trees and feed on leaves. Now see children in the picture. These animals, they are climbing up on a tree. Climb. These animals are climbing up on a tree. Next word is continued. What is the meaning? Without a break. In a flow. Now, let's read a sentence so the meaning become further clear to you. She continued to run until she won the race. This means that she was running and running and running without any break. Continued, happening constantly without any break. Now, what is the next word? Flames. A body of hot and glowing gas that comes from starting a fire. Now, see in the picture, where are the flames? These are the flames. They are coming out from a fire. These are flames. Now, let me share a sentence. Adding fuel to the fire produces a lot of flames. Now, whenever we add fuel to the fire, what becomes? A lot of flames, they emerge from the fire. Fireplace. An opening made in a chimney to hold an open fire. See children in the picture? This is a fireplace holding a fire. This is basically designed to keep the room warm. Let me share a sentence. In winters, everyone gathers around the fireplace. See children in the picture, there is a fireplace. And everyone gathers in winters around the fireplace. The next word is lid. A cover to close the opening of a container. Now see children, this is a lid. This is a lid. It is covering this jar. I do not think this is the right lid for the box. Or I do not think this is the right cover for the box. So the meaning of lid is the cover. The next word is iron spoon. This is the easiest word. I'm sure you must have seen spoons used for eating food. Now let's use this word spoon in a sentence. She ate a spoonful of rice. Now children, let's start our lesson. Before I will start reading, I will quickly give you a recap of part 1 so that it will become very easy for you to understand part 2. What happened in part 1? Yes, come on. If you remember? Yes. Once there was a big wolf. And that wolf wanted to eat three little goats, tiny horns, short horns, and long horns. They made house. Who made house? These three little goats, they made house from straw, which was blown up by the wolf. Then they made house with wood. Again, the wolf shook the house and broke it. Finally, they made house from bricks. The house made from bricks was very strong and wolf was unable to break it. So he climbed at the top of the roof and tried to enter in the house via chimney. Now let's read. Unit 2, Lesson 5, The Three Little Goats, Part 2. Read part 2 of the story and answer these questions. Now what are the questions? Where did the wolf start its climb? Where did it finish? Now children, while reading, you have to search for the answer. Where the wolf started its climb and where did it finish? The three little goats heard the wolf climb inside the top of the chimney. They were afraid. They were afraid. Oh no! The wolf is coming down the chimney! They shouted together. Quick! Said Tiny Horns. Put more sticks on the fire. It will be too hot for Wolfie. But the wolf continued to climb down the chimney. Quick! Said Short Thorns. Put some wet leaves on the fire. It will be too smoky for the wolfie. But the wolf continued to climb down the chimney. Quick! Said Longhorns. Put more sticks on the fire. Move the pan of hot water over the flames. The water will be too hot for Wolfie. Soon they could see the wolf's tail above the fireplace. Quick! Said Tiny Horns. Pull! So they pulled the wolf's tail and the wolf fell into the pot of boiling water. Short Horns hit the wolf on the head with a big iron spoon. Long Horns put the lid on the pot and Tiny Horns put a heavy stone on the lid. That was the end of the big bad wolf. So the wolf died and the three little goats lived happily ever after. Now children, we will start our exercise. We will start with this question. Question number one. Where did the wolf start its climb? Now children, please tell me. Where did the wolf start its climb? Absolutely correct. The wolf started its climb from the chimney. Where did it finish? Now where did it finish finally, children? It finally finished in the pot full of hot water. Question number two. Are these sentences true or false? What is the true sentence? The sentence which is correct, or the sentence which is giving correct information. A false sentence which is incorrect. Example. The wolf was too big to climb down the chimney. Is it correct? No, it's not. Wolf was climbing down the chimney easily. So this statement is false. This statement is false. Now let's do number one. The goats made the fire and water hotter. Is it true? Yes, this statement is true because they were adding wet leaves to make the fire more and water hotter. Number two. The wet leaves on the fire made the chimney very smoky. Is it true? Yes, they wanted to create more smoke so wolf will run away. Number three. The goat saw the wolf's head appear in the fireplace. Was it wolf's head that appeared? No, it was wolf's tail. So this statement is false. Number four. The wolf escaped from the pot. Is it true? No, not at all. This statement is false. Let's do question number three. Use your own words to complete these sentences. Now we have to complete the sentences given below. Number one, the third house didn't fall down because. Now we have to tell why the third house didn't fall down. Because it was built of bricks. Why the third house didn't fall down? Because it was made up of bricks. Number two, the wolf couldn't dash. So he climbed down the chimney. So this conjunction so indicates that we should have, there must be any problem. So we have to look for the problem. The wolf couldn't blow the house. The wolf couldn't blow the house. So he climbed down the chimney. Number three, the goats tried to make the fire hotter. So they put more sticks on the fire. So they put more sticks on the fire. Number four. The goats tried to make the chimney smoky. So they added wet leaves on the fire. So they added wet leaves on the fire. Number five. The goats pulled the wolf down by its tail and what happened? And It fell in the pot. And it fell in the pot. Number 6. The goats dash. So the wolf could not escape. Now, the goats put the lid on the pot and a heavy stone on the lid. So what happened? The wolf was unable to escape. The goats put a lid on the pot and a heavy stone on the lid. So the wolf could not escape. Very well done, children. Now, I will share answers with you so that you can check whether you have attempted these questions correctly or not. Here you go.